In April, a group of friends and I set off to do something a little daring. We decided that we were going to chase a shark. You see, I am a lover of the ocean. I live in Hawaii, and I spend my time in the water chasing things and being chased by all kinds of things. So a few weeks ago, we woke up bright and early, 6 a.m. We drove to the boat harbor, and from there, we set off for the middle of the ocean. On the boat ride over, the instructors talked about the misconceptions of sharks, what we should expect of our dive, and also safety precautions. They told us that we would each individually sit on the back of the boat, and that is where we would put on our fins and our mask. One thing that they said was very important is that we did not test the water. They said, you probably want to feel the water, but just brace yourself, it's going to be cold. Don't stick your hands in, don't stick your fins in, just jump in. This not only was for safety reasons, but actually the longer we waited, our chances of seeing sharks actually lessened. You see, sharks are very curious animals, and so when they see boats, they're much more likely to stay around if there is some activity happening. Comforting, I know. So it was my turn to put on my fins and my mask, and I started to feel that sense of fear in my gut. But knowing what the instructors told me, I pushed those fears aside, and I plunged into the deep blue. What I saw from here was absolutely incredible. These large, almost fake-looking creatures swimming around the perimeters of the boat. Yeah. What was interesting is that each shark had its own personality. Surprisingly, the large sharks actually moved more gracefully and glided through the water. They would be considered the chill sharks. But the smaller sharks had some spunk, and they moved really fast and would cut corners and move really jaggedly. So I see these sharks swimming around the perimeters of the boat, and I'm okay with that. I'm getting comfortable. But then I looked below my feet, and I didn't just see one shark or two sharks. But I saw about 40 more sharks swimming below me. I know. 40 more sharks swimming below me. But the longer I was in the water, the more I started to realize how beautiful of an experience this was. And that, to be honest, I really wasn't afraid anymore. And I started to look at the details of the sharks and see their black beady eyes and the gills on their side and notice how smooth their fins were. And I started to look at how incredibly blue the water was, that it was something I had never seen before, and that we were just two animals, two creatures swimming in it. And it's really hard for me to describe, and you probably won't believe me when I say this, but I almost felt connected and just at peace in the water. And I can definitely say it was an experience I will never forget. And afterwards, when I was looking at these pictures, I kept thinking, man, imagine if I wouldn't have just jumped in. Imagine if I would have backed out. I would have missed out on such a unique experience, and I know I would have regretted it, and I'm so glad that I just went for it. How many times in life do we miss out on amazing experiences because we don't just jump in? How many times do we take too long testing the water? I believe that every day we have the opportunity to experience something beautiful. Every morning, every single morning when we wake up, we are presented with a new opportunity to experience new things or to chase new things. On that particular day, I set out to chase a shark. But to be honest, a shark could represent anything in your life that terrifies you. So, if you are all interested in learning how to chase a shark, I'm going to tell you how to do it in three steps. Step number one, commit to the chase. You are never going to have the experience if you don't decide to follow through. However, the key is that once you commit to the chase, to not let any obstacles keep you from achieving it. So when my friends and family heard that I was going swimming with sharks, as you can imagine, I got a lot of different opinions and comments. I had some people just bluntly ask me, why would you even do that? Don't you know how dangerous sharks are? Or my personal favorite, haven't you seen the movie Jaws or The Shallows? Because those are realistic. But yes, I have seen those. But this is something that I wanted to do. This is something that I truly wanted to experience. And I had to remember that this is something I wanted to do before anyone even knew that I was planning on going. When opportunities arise in our lives, it is very easy for the opinions of others and even the voices in our own heads to become loud and distracting in our decision making. Whether it's doubt from your peers or the fear of your own failure or maybe even self-doubt, whatever it may be, do not let these hinder you from amazing opportunities. Commit to your chase and run with it. Step number two, get in the water. When it's time to jump in, you must have faith and let go. So while I was waiting for my turn to put on my fins and my mask, I'm looking out and I see this beautiful sky and mountains. But the surface of the water was very dark. I could not see what was below it. And there was that fear of the unknown, of I have no idea what's going to be under there when I jump in. For all I know, there'll be a shark right by my face when I get in the water. But I had to keep telling myself, Nikki, this is something you want to do. This is something you can do. You got this. You got this. And those thoughts superseded my fears. One of my favorite sayings is the Latin phrase, carpe diem, seize the day. Or all of you know the slogan for the brand Nike. So I say, live like Nike and just do it. That's my motto. Right? Thank you. So just do it. Seize the moments, whether they're big or small. And when opportunities arise, have faith in yourself, your desire, and most importantly, let go. Because once you let go of your fears is when you can fully enjoy the experience. And that's when you can take in the moment. Step three, live to tell the story. Sometimes people get discouraged during the chase, and they never end up telling anyone about their experience, or they quit in the chase. If you decide to chase a shark, do it to the best of your ability. And if you learn something along the way, then allow it to enhance your life. So, I dove in, I'm in the water, and it's my turn to tell the story. So if you decide to chase a shark, like I said, put in all of your ability, because if you do, you might be able to get some pictures like this. I swam as fast as I could whenever a shark would come near so I could get as close as possible to that shark, and it was hard. My legs were hurting, I was running out of breath, and when you have to dive deep in the ocean, the pressure in your ears start to build up, so I had to keep popping my ears along the way. And so there's a lot I have to think about as I'm trying to chase after this shark. But because I swam as fast as I could, because I channeled my inner Michael Phelps, I was able to get literally just a few feet away from these animals and create such a unique experience for myself. And it was worth it. It was absolutely worth it. This experience, like I said, is something I will never forget. Once you commit, once you jump in, put in all of your ability, because steps one and steps two will be a waste if you do not finish with all of your might. I wouldn't be sharing this story with all of you today. Yes, it was a cool experience for me, but I wouldn't be sharing it all with you today if I didn't allow it to enhance my own life, if I didn't learn something from it. So whatever your story is, whatever experience you end up having, learn from it and share it. Because you never know the impact that your experiences can have on other people. In closing, sometimes we get so caught up in our own fears, perceptions, misconceptions, that we deny ourselves of golden moments. Whether it's applying for your dream college, or achieving a career dream, facing a fear, or maybe learning a skill that you've always wanted to learn. Whatever opportunity gets open for you today, chase it and catch that shark. Thank you.